somebody else to do it.
From now on, nobody else cares.
I said I could get somebody else to do it.
From now on, nobody else carries Nita Wright's stuff but her own husband. Hey, what's this?
Nothing.
Hey, look over here, a cake.
There's nothing, Billy Joe. Come on, let's go. We don't have any time for this.
There's one second. There's a name on this here cake. Let's see. What? Well, it's for Elena. It's Elena's 18th birthday,
Billy
huh?
Joe. We don't have any time for this. It's none of our business. And besides, I don't want you and Maggie crossing paths again.
Well, just hold on a second. I'm not going to go hurrying and sneaking around like you've done something wrong. Maggie's a tough old turkey. She can take care of herself. Besides, I got to wish Elena a happy birthday. Don't I?
You do not. You don't have to say anything to her. You and her have gotten yourselves in enough trouble already. And besides, you promised me you weren't going to get in any more trouble. Now, you remember that?
Well, who's talking about trouble? I just want to wish the girl many happy returns, that's all. Oh, look, honey, look, I know what I promised. And I swear I ain't looking for any trouble either. Come on, Nita, you got to start giving me credit for knowing how to act, huh? Besides, maybe I might be able to do Elaine a favor.
Oh. How are you going to do her a favor?
I might be able to get her a gig, that's what. Hey, what is it? You ain't jealous of that school
girl? No, I am not jealous of... I am not jealous of Elena. I am here to get my things, and I want to get you out of here before Maggie sees you, so come on.
Come on here, sugar. Don't you know I love you, huh? Didn't I prove that to you already?
Yeah.
Didn't I just prove that a little while ago, huh? Sure I did. I love you, honey. I really do. I love you, and I love that little baby you're caring for me. Don't you know that? I'm not interested at all in that chick or any chick. Just you. I love you, Nita.
And why are you always making things harder for me?
Okay. Yeah. Sure, I came here to help you, right?
Yeah.
So I'm just going to get your stuff right now, show me where it is, and I'll bring it right over to our brand new house.
Oh.
Now what? What is this? You ain't never going to smile again?
No, I'm just worried is all.
Well, don't be.
What do you mean, don't be? I swear, Billy Joe, I don't know how you talked me into taking that fancy place. I must have something wrong with my head. It is too fancy, it is too expensive, and we cannot afford it.
Well, I just talked you into it the same way I always talk you into what's good for you, darling. That's all.
Cute.
You're so cute. You're so cute. Now, come, before I get all worked up, show me where your stuff is. Let's go. Come on.
It's not that way, Sugar Bumps.
Sugar?
I am living back there now.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Right.
Howdy, Miss Maggie.
Now, wait a minute, Maggie. He's just here to help me move some of my things. Won't be but a minute.
It's all right, just so long as he is out of here before time for Elena's party.
You ain't afraid of me or anything, are you, Maggie? Scared I might take that cake knife to your throat?
Okay, that's it. I'm gonna call the police.
No, please, Maggie, please. It's just his mouth running off with itself again. He didn't mean no harm.
That's exactly what he does mean, Nita. When are you going to realize that?
Didn't you hear anything, huh? I was just joking about the cake knife. I'm a new man. I'm reformed. Didn't Nita tell you that?
That'll be the day, Billy Joe Wright. Now listen to me, Nita. I want him out of here because I do not want that child's birthday party spoiled.
He will be. He will be, Nick.
Boy, that's how you know you're getting old. When a girl stacked like the world building still looks like a child to you.
Texas, starring Beverly McKenzie.
Oh. Hi. Venison stew, huh? Looks good. What happened to your hand?
Oh, that's nothing. I just sprained my thumb.
I hope you know that... I can't eat all of that because it was a surprise party over at Maggie's for Elena. You know about that?
Yeah, I know all about that. Had a long talk with Maggie. No, you see, I always cook for 10. Out of habit. Yep. Just in case somebody ends up at my door hungry.
Oh, it smells good.
Well, there'll be some here tomorrow. But you just wait till you see that spread Maggie's gonna have laid out for you.
Well, how do I look? Well?
Well, I can tell you. You look about 10 years older than that girl I saw off to school this morning.
But of course I do. Haven't you heard the world turns a lot faster than it ever did before, Kate? Especially here in Houston. Or New York.
Well, I don't know about that. Reading your fashion magazines again, haven't you?
Well, what do you think? Do I look like the New York woman?
You've been reading the wrong issue. Because, you know, if you go to New York dressed like that, you know where you're going to end up? Bellevue, pneumonia ward.
That's not what I meant.
I know that.
Well, then why are you always teasing
me? Because it makes you mad, that's why. Oh. Now, you look good. You look real good. You look just like a New York woman. That's what you want to be.
Oh, well, it may not be as cold here as it is in New York, but we don't want you to catch cold and end up sick. So here you are.
Oh, thank you, Kate.
It's from the Marshalls. Each and every one of us wish you a long and happy life.
Thank you.
Well, open it up.
I'm gonna open it up.
It's not vanity to tell the truth. And you are beautiful.
Kate.
Just as beautiful as your mother was. And honey, I want you to stay as fresh and radiant and beautiful for the rest of your life.
Oh, thank you, Kate.
Look after her.
Yes, ma'am.
It's all right. Just step back.
Oh, honey, I would not want you to get in his way now that he's on his way out of here for once and for all. I do not want him delayed.
Amen. Whose birthday is it, Maggie?
It's Elena's. I meant to tell you this morning. I'm having a little surprise party. Some of the family, a few friends coming in. You think you can stay?
Sure. I don't have any plans.
Good. In fact, why don't you ask that nice Bart Walker to come along with you? You know, I was thinking about asking him myself this afternoon, but I didn't want you to think I was matchmaking.
Oh, no, never.
No. Well, I always thought there might have been a little something between the two of you, you know. No.
Hmm? Ever since everything fell apart between Kevin and I haven't exactly been dreaming about romance. I mean, Bart's a good friend and he's a good partner, but...
That's all he means to you.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'd say that's a lot. I feel comfortable with him. Safe. I guess that's because I know he's my friend.
Honey, I'm not blind, and I can tell you that Bart Walker has a whole lot more in mind than just being your friend or your partner.
Well, I'm not in the market for anything more than that. Sorry. So what time is Max bringing Elena in? Do I have time to change my clothes?
Oh, honey, you got plenty of time, but Max isn't bringing her in.
He's not?
No, Jeb Hampton is. You see, it seems like he promised her he'd take her out for her 18th birthday, and so he seemed the logical one to bring her in for the surprise party.
Oh. I see. Well, maybe I will go call Bart after all.
Good.
Excuse me.
Kind of you to drop your whole busy schedule, come see me home. feel rather like a wayward child.
Well, we can't have you missing a doctor's appointment, can we?
It was kind, but it was also rather extravagant and unnecessary, wouldn't you say?
No, I wouldn't say. You see, Iris's well-being is very important to me.
Well, of course, and to me. But I was here, and I'd already promised to see Iris safely back to Houston.
Well, you see, I consider it part of my responsibility. I promised Alex that I'd take as good a care of Iris as he would himself. I'm sure if Alex was here now, well, he would be here to take his wife home.
No doubt.
Shall we have our seats?
Wonderful takeoff. Very smooth. I wager she's equipped with the latest gyrocompass design.
Well, as a matter of fact, it is. Are you familiar with that sort of gadgetry, Elliot?
Oh, only what I picked up chasing down a few spy stories. Not as much as you, I'm sure. I understand that government security used to be your profession.
Well, running World Oil is my business now. You comfortable, Iris?
Yes, I'm fine.
You know, it's a shame that we haven't had a chance to get better acquainted.
Well, I'm sure we've both been very busy, haven't we?
Well, yes, but it's a pity, really. I mean, since Iris and my son share the assets of World Oil with you, and since you manage those assets, well, it only makes sense that we should come to know one another better.
I agree.
Oh, good.
Well, then perhaps you could start by explaining to me why this all concerns you so much. I mean, since Iris is your ex-wife by, what, 15 years? And since Dennis happens to be Alex's son.
He wants more of his kitchen. He looks up girl like that. I can tell.
Hi.
So I'm sure I'm not dreaming. Oh, darling, that's so wonderful. Oh, I've waited all day for that.
All day? What did you do, get up early?
Well, half the afternoon, but it's an eternity just the same. You know, it's funny, Dennis. I used to love it there when I first moved in. You know, being at the very tip of the top of the world with all of Houston spread at my feet, I thought it was seventh heaven.
It isn't?
Not anymore. Not since... Oh, Dennis, now I wake up and I can't stand how empty my bed is. And it is, darling, without you. See, I keep remembering how warm and wonderful it was waking up beside you on New Year's Day.
Oh, please. I get a hangover just thinking about New Year's Day.
Dennis, but it was so lovely.
Yeah, well, I'm glad you had rosy memories of that morning. To me, it was more tinted, a sort of bilious green.
Oh, darling! How can you say such a thing about one of the happiest mornings of my life? It was wonderful.
Well, you were wonderful, but my hangover cast an evil spell on everything else.
Yeah, you're a stinko, all right. As a matter of fact, like I told Miss Page when I helped her cart you home, I told you you're going to regret that night come morning.
Yeah, well, it's hard to regret something you don't remember.
Yeah, blackout, huh?
An eclipse, at the least.
Oh, darling, I've told you everything important that happened that day. Most important thing being your proposal. Dennis, you were so sweet.
Yeah? You really managed to propose that night? Man, oh, man.
He certainly did.
That's downright amazing. I don't think you could have said your name that night, much less propose.
Wait a minute. I thought I proposed right here in the club. And you overheard every word of it.
Me?
Oh, honey, I just love parties.
Hey, Maggie, how are you doing?
Hi. That Reno, honey, pretty. The place looks just beautiful, yeah. Maggie. Wait a minute, maybe I better start calling you Aunt Maggie. Have you heard the good news? We're about to be kin, sweetheart. Max and I are going to tie the knot.
A tying it loose enough to breathe now.
Oh, no. None of those slip knots you use on horses. Isn't it wonderful? Oh, I couldn't be happier, Rena. But you know, I think you forgot you told me one time already that night you and Justin were in here having dinner. Oh, I forgot all about that. Oh, look at this. Oh, isn't that...
Just slipped your mind, huh? What's this about you and Justin having dinner?
Well, of course, honey.
What do you mean, of course?
Oh, well, now, come on. Don't be so silly. I had to tell him we were engaged. Sweetheart, he's friends of both of us. You don't look so cross at me.
Well, just how did old Justin take the news?
He was as happy for both of us as he could be.
I'll bet.
He thought it was a wonderful idea. Oh, will you put that down, please?
Hello, Maggie.
Hello. How good
and
to see
Stryker,
you.
Stryker, how wonderful to see you looking so well.
You are looking at a medical miracle, Maggie. They not only gave me a young man's heart, but the appetite to go with it.
Yeah, well, we're going to have to see what we can do about that now.
Well, my little girl took care of the rest of it. Oh. Hi, honey.
Hi, Stryker.
Hello,
Maddie.
Miss Bell?
Hello, Maggie. Hi, darling.
You don't know how happy I am, Maggie, that my daughter had the good sense to pick your nephew to marry.
We picked both of each other, didn't we?
Well, actually, I think we just kind of fell into each other's arms out of pure exhaustion from fighting so much.
Well, when is the big wedding day gonna be?
What? Well, how about Friday?
Rena, dear, so soon? Well, there are so many plans to make. The dress, the church.
Oh, honey, none of that fancy stuff for us. We're just a couple of down-home Texans, right, honey?
That's my girl. That's you.
I want this to be one wedding where everybody has fun.
You know, she's right. I would give double her dowry if I could just get out of wearing that monkey suit of mine. Say, how about a barbecue?
In the middle of winter?
Oh, we put up a tent in case it rains.
Oh, Daddy, that's perfect.
How do you like the sound of that?
Sure.
Son? Well, that's terrific. Mac, you be an angel and cater my daughter's wedding, will you? And round us up a band or two, will
All
you?
All right.
Good
oh,
one.
I would love to do that, Stryker.
Good.
But now let me see. Friday, well, you know, that's my big night around here. Oh. But now I'm closed on Mondays.
Oh, we'll make it Monday. Does everyone agree?
Good. Honey, we're gonna be married on Monday. Woo! Oh,
huh? Heard you propose. I'll tell you, man, I was too busy lugging you around to hear your mumbling. Oh, yeah, propose. Sure, that just slipped my mind. I guess I thought you were just joking around the time you said
him.
Oh, well, there's a guy over there. I think he needs his drink. I don't want him to complain to management. So, y'all excuse me?
Yes,
nice chatting with you folks.
I think that'd be a good idea, Junior.
You know, you really ought to teach that clown to dance a lot
Come
better
on,
than that.
Just forget
Come on,
him.
You lied to me, Paige. Proposed to you. It was all a lie, wasn't it?
I thought we had an agreement.
No, Elliot.
Iris didn't tell me about Dennis.
Don't cover for her. I should have learned not to trust her by now.
No, Alex told me about Dennis months ago. He wanted me to understand the changes in his will.
Forgive me, Iris.
And that's not all he told me. He said you threatened to kill Iris when you found out about Dennis.
Oh, no. No, no, I didn't.
Oh, I believe that you did. You see, Alex wouldn't lie about that. And he wouldn't have been so concerned about what you might do to Iris.
I wouldn't do anything to harm Iris. I'm not a violent man. Oh, yes, I said some terrible angry words, words I've regretted 1,000 times, but it wasn't a serious threat. It was shock, that's all. A blind reaction. You understood that, didn't you, Iris?
You frightened me, Elliot. You frightened me badly.
For which I beg your forgiveness. You can see how the news might have made me lose control temporarily. I mean, for 25 years, Dennis was my son. Then suddenly, he wasn't my son anymore. He was the son of the man my wife betrayed me with.
Hey, that's enough of that, mister.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry. It still burns. But it's past. I have adjusted to the new order. I can live with it.
Well, I don't believe that. Or you wouldn't be so upset remembering it, would you?
What does it matter what you believe? It's my life. And I have to make living with it a reality.
Well, it matters to me because you're still clutching it, Dennis, like a drowning man. And you're still holding it over Iris. Now tell me, Elliot, why did you make Iris promise not to tell Dennis?
It was time to be made to give up everything. What purpose could it serve to break the bond between Dennis and me? Wheeler doesn't need a son now. I do. He took my wife away from me before she even was my wife. He cannot take my son.
No, he can't. Can he, Elliot?
I'm sorry he's gone, but he is gone. Dennis loves me without question. He's the only one in the world who does. He understands me. He forgives me. I'd freeze without that one touch with humanity. I would die without my son.
Forgives you? Forgives you what, Elliot?
We all have need of forgiveness, haven't we, Connor? Isn't that one of the rules of the world? Or are you so perfect that you've never felt the need of a merciful word from someone who loves you?
No, Elliot, I'm not perfect. But do you really think you can base the kind of relationship you crave with Dennis on a lie?
Something as important as that? I mean, something that you'd know that you'd said because of the way that you feel?
How do I feel? I don't even know how I feel. I've been so confused since I met you.
Darling, that's love, Dennis.
Maybe. But I am still not a fool. You know, ever since you told me that story about how I proposed to you, I've had my doubts. And now with that clown running around, talking the way he was? Yeah, I think you would lie about me proposing to you. In fact, I think that's exactly what you did. Well, I'm right, aren't I?
I told you from the very beginning that if you wanted out, you could forget the whole thing. No matter how much it hurt me to lose you. Hey, listen, I'm tough. I can live. I may never be happy, that's all.
And you admit it?
Yes. Yes, okay. All right, I admit it. I admit that I loved you so much. And then that I was so crazy about you and wanted you so much that I was glad when Dawn broke off your engagement. Yes.
Will you just give me a straight answer? Did you lie when you said I proposed to you?
Maybe I hoped I was reading your mind. All right, it was a lie. Dennis, can you forgive my lie?
Yeah. you promise never to lie to me again. And don't tell me what I think, all right?
Oh, darling. Of course I won't. I won't lie to you again, ever. I promise you. That was just to bring us together. Dennis, you don't really want to break off our engagement?
Why should I?
Because I lied to you. Can you really forgive me?
I guess I'm flattered that you want to marry me. I've never had that kind of luck before.
Oh, darling. You've just never had the right woman before. I'm going to make you so happy. I really love you, Dennis.
This is not what I had in mind at all.
You'll like it.
I will not like it, Jeb. Look, this is supposed to be my special night. It's my birthday, right? I don't want to go to my Aunt Maggie's. Jeb, I don't want to go here.
Yeah, but Maggie's has got the best food in town.
Well, I don't want to eat. I want to drink.
I know that, but you have to eat first before you can drink. Besides, wait a minute. Who do you think you're with? Howard Hughes? I don't have a lot of money. Besides, Maggie's is good, and it's cheap. And then after this, I'll take you anywhere you want to go, and I'll get you an after-dinner drink.
Oh, one drink? That's not my idea of a celebration.
All right, then. We will go someplace, anywhere you want to go, and we'll drink ourselves into oblivion. Because I think you need to get that out of your system, so you'll stay away from the booze then.
Oh, now I don't have any sense at all, right?
No, I didn't say that. Look, all right, it's cold out here. We don't want to stand out here and argue. Let's go inside, all right?
All right.
Okay, now come on. Now, I also want you to get a nice smile on your face. All right, no, put a nice big smile
That's
on it.
That's a nice big smile.
Good. Now keep it there, all right?
Happy birthday. Now, he didn't tell you, did he? Were you surprised?
I was more like shocked.
Oh, honey, you shouldn't have done this.
What do you mean I shouldn't have fun when my niece is all grown up?
Come on now, I've got something to see. Come on. Look at this. Look at everybody, come on.
Light this.
All right, let me do it right here. All right. A little bit more.
Easy on those presents. Now, let's do this right. You got to do the cake first, and then you can get to the presents. Besides, you're not officially 18 until you've blown out all the candles, you see, so that's why we got to get
these. Well, they're not exactly lit yet, Meg.
Make a wish for something big and beautiful.
Uh-huh. Everybody's got to say now. Come on, Nita, start for us.
Oh. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Lena. Happy birthday to you. Woo!
You get to open your gifts. Come on.
I can't wait to open this.
I bet you never guess what it is.
Oh, I bet I could guess what this is.
Hey, Jim.
There you go. I got it.
Oh, it's gorgeous. I love it. Thank you.
Hello. Hi.
Hi.
Oh, Jim Hampton, isn't it? Right.
I'm Dr. Bart Walker. I introduced you before.
That's right. I remember.
Bart is my partner. We have a clinic very nearby.
That's terrific.
And of course, Jeb is my former patient.
Yeah, I guess she told us she saved my life. And are you willing to say that I did the same
thing? Oh, that's nice.
Well, since he does have the bad manners to bring it up, I never really did tell you what went wrong between Kevin and I.
And you don't have to, Court.
Oh, Bart, you're really nice.
Oh, but I insist, because it is such a simple thing. You see, this is what went wrong.
Thank you so much,
Mr. Well, you know, Vicky picked it out for you.
Now, listen, everybody, now that she's seen all her non-edible gifts, Nita and I got a couple more surprises.
We
everybody
sure
now take a seat, and we're going to bring some things out. Come on. Okay. All the good of you.
Thank you.
You bet, honey. Oh, lots more happy birthdays.
The guitar is still my favorite gift of all. It's perfect. Exactly what I want.
I'm glad you like it. Can you really play one of these things?
Well, I'm getting better.
Got yourself a new teacher.
I certainly do. I still don't know how you talk Max into getting me a guitar. I'm sure he would have rather have gotten me a sewing machine or something.
Oh, Pooh! Actually, it was Jeb's idea, though. You know, just between you and me and Jeb, I think we're going to be able to soften a little old Max.
Well, I'm jealous, but thank you.
Enjoy.
Spill this stuff out.
Jeb, why don't we go sit with Max and Rita? You can tell me how hard I've been.
Hi, Corey. Mind if I join you?
No, of course not. Please sit down. Have you two met?
Not really.
Oh, no. This is Dr. Bart Walker, Terry Decker. Bart is my partner.
Oh, sexy voice on the telephone.
We've been talking back and forth so much, it's about time we met.
You have?
Why? Yeah, well, Ryan wanted Barrett questioned under a drug that Bart administered, so I set up the appointment.
Well, you haven't mentioned how it went, Bart. Could he remember anything more?
Well, I guess I don't talk much about the failures. I'm sorry, I should have kept you informed.
So I take it didn't work?
No.
Why not? Head injury?
No. There's no organic brain damage. It's something more complex and subtle than that.
Well, that's a relief.
You're right, of course. If his loss of memory had had physical causes, it would have been irreversible.
So what you're saying is that it's psychological and it might come back to him.
Yes. But I think, although I'm not an expert, that it'll take a lot of time and analysis to get to the root of the trauma.
Do you recommend that Barrett keep trying? Thank you.
Ryan feels it's necessary.
Of course he does, for his benefit, but not for Barrett's welfare, isn't that right?
Well,
he is my brother. He is your patient. Don't you think you should put Barrett's welfare above whatever Ryan Connor wants from him?
Courtney, he's blocking something. Something big, something that's haunting him. Now, I don't know what it is or why he's buried it so deep in his psyche, but it could prove as dangerous to him as a tumor. Unless we find out what it is and relieve the pressure it's putting on his mind, he could one day just explode.
Oh, so what you're saying is that my brother is a potentially dangerous man. Well, I don't believe it, Bart. I don't buy it. I know my brother.
The point is that in some ways, Barrett doesn't know himself anymore and won't unless we get to the root of the psychological trauma that led to his loss of memory. Trust me. I wouldn't go on with the treatment unless it was best for him in the long run.
Then wait 6 months. Just 6 months. It might be easier on him if you give him more time.
I think the sooner the better.
Do you? Or is that what Ryan Connor thinks?
Courtney, believe me, Ryan has very good, very important reasons for wanting Barrett to remember what happened the last year.
Listen, don't think because you got me in the middle of family hour that I intend to stay here all night long, because you promised me a drink at the top of the World Club. So can we get out of here soon? Please.
Me with a little talent and a lot of love. Mm-hmm, good. Just right amount, too.
This is it. This is what I want.
I don't know what you want to be in this place for with a lot of strangers. Be with your family. So you're weird.
You're the weird one. I've been with my family all my life. And that party we just left reminded me of the one I had when I was 13 years old. Pink roses and all.
Wait a minute. Let me tell you something. You ought to be glad that you got a family that cares about you. Now, you know that?
Yes. They're wonderful. I know that. Now, you think it's okay if we forget about them for an hour? Please?
Fine.
All right. Come on.
Hey, well, look who's here.
Are you surprised to see me?
Heck, no. Where else would you want to be on your 18th birthday? Happy birthday, Sugar Bumps!
How did you know?
Well, Billy Joe Rat has his ways. Why don't
don't get a table, okay?
Because at a table, they'd make this woman pay for her drink. But me, as far as I'm concerned, your first legal drink is on the house. Will it be, Dow?
Well, at least someone knows how to celebrate an 18th birthday.
You're darn right.
I would like something very special.
You know, I got just the thing. A brand new drink. It's called Right Now. Named after myself, see?
Well, what's in it?
Well, I'll tell you what. It's kind of a secret, but I just say magic. As a matter of fact, it's guaranteed to make the woman who drinks it fall madly in love with the bartender who fixed it for her. You want one, too?
Whiskey, whiskey. And less lip.
Ooh, Mr. Cheerful. Sure got yourself a sour boyfriend here. And I was just going to give you a hot tip, too. If you folks are planning on making rounds tonight.
No, we're not.
Yes, we are. What?
Well, there's this little late hours place, you know? It's near Maggie's. As a matter of fact, it got me a job there. It's called the Chicken Coop. And, well, let me tell you, that place really starts jumping after midnight, you know? Got a nice country band and all. And I can fix it up so you can sing a couple numbers with them if you like. Make it a real coming out party. What do you say?
Look, we're not interested, okay?
Is that talking to you? What do you say, Elena? I tell you, the band is really good, but they need a voice like yours up front.
Oh, Jeb, let's go.
Well, I said forget it.
I thought this was my night.
Elena, I don't want you going to this place and getting up on stage and pretending like you're a singer, because you're not ready yet.
This ain't the Metropolitan Opera, buddy.
Look, why don't you just butt out? Why don't you do your job and get us a few drinks
Listen,
here, all right?
You're in my place now. I'm the one who tells people either to butt out or get out. You got nothing to say at the top of the world, you hear me?
Last time you had a lucky punch.
Now, come on, don't go spoiling my birthday. Sit down.
I'm not. This banana is.
Hey, all I'm doing is offering the lady a little opportunity here. She can take it or leave.
Well, she's leaving it.
I speak for myself, Jeb.
Elena, you're not ready, all right?
Not ready? You're crazy, man. You know that? I heard this girl sing before. She could sing 6 months ago.
I'd really like to sing tonight.
You can sing tonight or as many nights as you want. I can get you a steady gig if you want.
No.
What's the matter, buddy? Afraid you might lose control over this girl or something, huh? Now, why do you want to go sabotaging her career for, huh?
You can really get me a regular paying job.
Sure can. Good pay, too. I'll tell you something. All you got to do is sing, please the people, please the crowd. I'll make you a star. You don't need this clown.
A regular singing job?
Drink up.
Iris, nice to see you.
Thank you.
You look wonderful. Well, I have your room all arranged, so you can get an early night's sleep. And tomorrow morning, we'll begin the tests.
Good. Not too early, I hope.
Well, they'll be knocking on your door at about, 7 a.m.
Dear. I'm going to bed now. Look, there is no reason for me to take up any more of your time. Elliot, I want to thank you for being so thoughtful and concerned about me.
Well, I'll stay and make sure you're comfortable.
No. Oh, really, that's not necessary. I want some time alone to settle in. It's been a bit of a whirlwind.
Yes, it has it now. Very well. Rest well. I'll call on you in the morning. Gentlemen, good night.
Elliot.
Thank you again, Elliot. Mm-hmm. It is hard to believe he could be a killer.
Well, don't doubt it for a minute, Iris.
No. No, I'm convinced you're right. I want to thank both of you. I couldn't have made my story believable alone. Oh, I'm so tense. I tell you, all this improvising, it's been exhausting.
Oh. Well, you did very well.
I had to protect Alex.
And you did. At least we have Elliot now where we can watch him. And safely away from Alex, too.
Yes, thank goodness. There's just one thing I don't understand, Ryan. Why did you grill Elliot so severely on the flight home? It made me terribly nervous.
Well, I wanted to shake him up, make him nervous. I had to.
But why? Won't that make him even more suspicious?
I hope so. You see, up to now, we've been playing it safe, but that's just not going to work anymore. Time's going to be on Elliot's side, not ours.
Yes, I see. I think.
Look, we have to prove that Elliot shot Alex soon or make him confess. Because before long, he's going to realize that Alex must be alive. And if he does, well, he'll be going after him again.
Ryan, excuse me. Iris, how would it be if I saw you to your room?
Yes, thank you.
See you soon, Iris.
Yeah.
I don't know why we had to come home so early.
Early? What are you talking? It's after 1 o'clock.
Yeah, well, I wanted to go to that place, the chicken coop. I wanted to sing.
Some other night, all right? I don't know why you want to go to a place called the chicken coop for anyway. I mean, there'd just be a lot of flights hanging around, like, what? Yeah, Billy Bud? What the heck's that guy's
Billy
name?
Billy Joe.
Billy Joe.
And I think it was really nice of him to offer me a job.
Yes. Seems like a very nice guy. Elena, I don't see why you have to, you know, start your career off. Now, you don't have to shove everything into your 18th birthday here.
No, but I do have to start my adult life on the right track.
Well, staying out of flaky bars like that is starting off on the right track.
Well, I know that there are some things more important, even than singing.
You're right about that. I'm glad you see it. Congratulations.
Well, like you. Jeb, I love you.
You're too much, you know that? Happy birthday. I'm real fond of you, too.
Jeb, I want more. Look, I know you would love me like I love you if you would just let it go and if you would just let it happen.
Listen, I promised a lot of people that I was going to protect you tonight, okay? Now, staying here in this car like this is not doing any good for that promise. It's not doing you any good either. Or me. Let's go inside.
All right, so maybe you don't love me. But at least I'm gonna have my singing career starting tonight.
Wait a minute, all right?
Look, our deal was good only until my 18th birthday, and that is over as of tonight. And tomorrow I'm gonna march myself down to the chicken coop. And I am going to make them want me.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.
I know that there are some things more important, even than singing.
You're right about that. I'm glad you see it. Congratulations.
Well, like you. Jeb, I love you.
You're too much, you know that? Happy birthday. I'm real fond of you, too.
Jeb, I want more. Look, I know you would love me like I love you if you would just let it go and if you would just let it happen.
Listen, I promised a lot of people that I was going to protect you tonight, okay? Now, staying here in this car like this is not doing any good for that promise. It's not doing you any good either. Or me. Let's go inside.
All right, so maybe you don't love me. But at least I'm going to have my singing career starting tonight.
Wait a minute, all right?
Look, our deal was good only until my 18th birthday. And that is over as of tonight. And tomorrow I'm going to march myself down to the chicken coop. And I am going to make them want me.
Oh, morning, Ginny. You ready for breakfast?
Oh, no, thank you.
Nothing? Not even some coffee?
I just had some soda crackers.
Soda crackers. That is not breakfast. Are you sick?
No. Well, maybe a little.
Well, maybe you ought to go back to bed?
No, it's not catching.
Are you sure?
Yeah, pretty sure. I did make an appointment with Dr. Walker, though, just in case.
Oh, he's really nice.
Yeah, I like him.
Well, when's your appointment?
Today.
After school?
No, this morning. Why?
I need a ride into town.
Didn't you have enough of the big city last night, birthday girl?
Mm-mm. Not for me, not nearly enough.
Oh, I see.
But I am going to get me some more of it. You wait and see.
Well, you better watch out. I don't think Max would like
that. I don't care what Max thinks. I'm going to get a job in town, Ginny.
A job? Lena, what are you talking about? Are you thinking about dropping out of school?
Well, maybe. I'm 18 now.
I know that, but it...
No buts! Look, I am tired of all of this school stuff. I'm an adult now, and I think it's time that I earn my own living.
How do you earn your keep right?
Well, if I can do it here, then I can do it someplace else, can't I? You better get Steve to hurry up. The school bus is going to be...
Elena!
Look, don't worry, Ginny. I'm not going to quit school until I get...
Elena, wait a second. Now, I want to talk to you more about these plans of yours.
Texas, starring Beverly McKenzie.
Kevin, I just feel terrible about taking up hospital space when I'm not even ill. There are people who need this room.
I understand how you feel, Iris. Try and think of... Think of it as preventive medicine. I'll arrange for you to have a thorough examination.
Even though it's unnecessary?
Well, is it? It might keep Elliot Carrington's suspicions at bay.
I wish I'd never told him I had to return for tests.
Well, at least it does explain your leaving St. Croix so abruptly.
But lies have a way of breeding more lies to cover themselves.
Tell me about it. I've had enough trouble myself trying to keep the fact that Alex survived a secret.
It isn't easy, is it?
I promised myself and my blood pressure I'd never do it again. Believe me, never again.
I understand. I'm hardly looking forward to lying to Dennis or any friends who might call here concerned about me.
Oh, just a moment.
Dear. Thank you. Come in. Oh.
Hello, Dr. Cook.
Hello, Dennis. Nice to see you.
Hello, darling.
Dad told me you were here.
Oh, well, that was thoughtful of him, but unnecessary.
Why didn't you tell me yourself?
Well, because it isn't all that serious, and I didn't want to worry you.
How serious is it?
Well...
I think I'll leave that to your mother to explain, Dennis. How's that? All right, Iris? Bye-bye.
So long. All right, Mom, now what's going on?
chocolate syrup always sticks to the bottom of the glass.
All right, ready? There. Now, it's not at the bottom. Hurry up and break it, will you?
Morning. My head hurts.
What's wrong with your head, Uncle Jeb?
Well, what happened was...
Listen, stop playing with the food and drinking. Will you just hurry up? You're going to miss the bus.
I was just being polite to Uncle Jeb, and you don't have to fuss at me. I'm not hungry anymore.
Oh, Steve, you sure you don't want any
Will
of these
you leave him alone?
Why are you so mad at us, Mom?
I'm not mad. I'm not mad. I'm just nervous. I'm sorry, Annie.
Look, Steve, I tell you what. We'll give you one of these biscuits. We'll wrap it up so you can eat it on the bus. That way you don't... Or maybe you can give it away or something. Trade it off.
Even put some syrup on it for you.
Yeah, that looks good.
Woo! There you go. It's made at lunchbox, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Bye, Mom. Bye, sweet.
Thanks, Uncle Jeff.
Anytime, Steve. Anytime.
Oh, Steve, will you do me a favor and tell Elena that I want to talk to her after school, okay?
Uh-huh.
Thanks, honey. Got everything?
Yeah.
Bye.
Say, what do you want to talk to Elena about? No, wait, I want some coffee. You want some coffee?
No, thanks.
So what do you want to talk to Elena about?
Elena is thinking about quitting school and getting herself a job.
Yeah.
You know about that?
Somebody she knows offered her a job singing in a bar.
Who does she know in Houston?
I don't know who it was. Don't worry about it. The guy ain't gonna hire her.
What if he does, though?
Well, then he hires her.
Oh, Jeb, you've got to talk to her. You're the only one around here that she'll listen to.
No, that's not gonna work. I can't pull that anymore. I mean, I can't force her to do that. If she wants to... Look, I can't look after Elena anymore. I mean, I'm getting tired of doing that.
I thought you cared about her.
I do care about her. I care about a lot of people. And I hope that everything works out for her. I hope she has a nice career and everything like that. But I need some time for myself because I got to figure out how I can patch things up with Courtney.
Courtney can take care of herself, but I don't think Elena can. I really don't want you to walk out on her.
No, you're right. I'm not going to do that again. I'll talk to her after school, okay?
Okay.
You know what I think I'm going to do this morning? I think I'm going to make us breakfast. I'm going to make us some eggs. Maybe pancakes. Oatmeal. How about oatmeal? That's what I'm going to do. I make oatmeal. Bacon.
Kevin expects everything to be fine, so there's nothing to worry about.
Well, Dad sure seemed pretty concerned.
Oh, well, you know how he can be sometimes. When I told him Kevin wanted me back for tests, Elliot insisted I fly back immediately. There was just no arguing with him.
Yeah. Did Dr. Cook say how long the tests will take?
Not long, darling. A day or two. By then, the yacht should be back in Houston.
You're going back again?
Yes. Honey, I'll be all right.
I hope so. I mean, you had me worried there for a while. I mean, losing Alex like that.
I think things are better now.
Then the trip did you some good.
Yes.
And you're ready to start a new life all over again?
Ready? And even anxious, too.
Good. I'm glad to hear that. And I'm sure Dad will be glad to hear that, too.
Elliot?
Yeah. Why do you look so surprised? Don't you think he's been worried about you, too?
Well, he'll see in a few days that there's nothing to worry about.
Well, you don't think that's going to stop him, do you?
What do you mean?
I mean, he really wants us to be a family again.
I don't.
Mom,
what Elliot and I had is over.
Can't you at least give it another chance?
No.
You know, that's what I like about you, Mom. You're so warm, so loving. You really care about the people who love you, about what they want. Well, you know, I would like to see the two of you back together again.
You are wrong to hope for that.
I don't see anything wrong
with
it.
Well, that's because you don't know what our life together was like.
Well, then maybe you better just tell me.
Dennis,
Look, Mom, You're hiding something. Now, come on, just tell me what it is.
Dr. Cook.
Hello, Kevin. This is Ryan.
Hi, yes, Ryan.
Look, I'm just calling to find out if everything's okay with Iris.
Well, I just left her with Dennis. We'll keep her here for tests until Alex arrives back with the yacht.
Well, we didn't only have that long to shake Barrett's memory. Look, are we going to be able to do it?
Well, I hate to sound negative, Ryan, but after the sodium pentothal interview, Bart and I feel another session would be fruitless.
Well, why is that?
Well, sometimes amnesia is a protective device. Barrett needs analysis. If he's trying to forget something, we force him, it might be too great a strain on him.
Look, maybe we could get Elliot to think we're getting results, you know?
Have him think Barrett's beginning to remember what really did go on in that camp.
Oh, wait a minute. If we do that, isn't there a danger Elliot might go after Barrett?
Yeah, but I think that's the kind of risk a man like Barrett might be willing to take. Look, I'm going to have him come by today. I'll ask him. I think he just might cooperate.
Come on, Mom. What is it?
It's Alex. I mean, his memory is just too dear for me to ever be close to Elliot again.
I don't buy that. You're hiding something else, Mom. Is it something to do with Dad?
In a way, yes. I don't trust Elliot anymore.
Oh, come on.
He's not the man he used to be. His imprisonment has changed him. He frightens me.
You know, I really don't understand you. That man has done everything in his power to make sure that you're safe.
Oh, has he?
Yes.
He threatened my life, or have you forgotten that?
You said that was unimportant, that he was upset.
Oh, do you go around threatening people's lives when you're upset?
No, but
you... No buts. Elliot is dangerous. I don't trust him, and I don't think you should either.
Look, being in the jungle shook him up a lot. And he has been acting strange lately. But he is still my father, and I still love him. Look. You're the one who always said families have to forgive and forget. You're the one who's always coming to me saying, please, Dennis, I'm sorry for mixing in. I'm sorry for this, and I'm sorry for that. Please, Dennis, forgive me. I am still your mother. Well, he's still my father.
Dennis,
and I'll tell you something else, Mom. This little turnaround of yours is not going to separate me from my father.
That isn't what I want.
Isn't it? Yes, it is, Mom. That's what you've always wanted. You've always wanted me to be cut off from my friends so that you could dominate my life. Well, you can't do that anymore, Mom. I'm just not a child.
I know that, Dennis.
Look, Mom. I'm just not going to turn on my father. You're going to have to understand that.
Dennis.
Just...
Seen Justin in any place?
He's taping an interview, I think. You're welcome to wait for him.
Oh, I don't know. I've got a million things to do today. I'm getting married Monday.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Getting married. Mm-hmm. To Justin.
Not on your life, honey. No, I just came by to invite him.
I see.
That is, if he doesn't keep me waiting too long.
Oh, I don't think so.
Good. May I sit and wait?
Yes.
Elliot, I'd love to invite you to the wedding if you'd like to come.
Oh, I don't think so, Rena.
Well, now, listen, if you think it's going to be one of those dried-up society weddings, you just stop worrying. It's going to be more like a family reunion barbecue.
Well, it sounds like fun.
Then you'll come?
Well, I don't know. I may not be free.
Ooh, sounds very mysterious. Who's the lucky lady?
Oh, Iris. She's in Gulf Coast Hospital having some tests done.
Iris? Well, what's the matter with her?
Well, they don't know, which is why they're giving her a whole battery of tests.
Oh, dear. I better go see her in the hospital. Thanks for telling me.
Well, not at all, but I'm surprised you hadn't known.
Well, our relationship sort of withered after Alex. You see, Iris got so mad at me for defending Justin that...
Justin tell you how much he appreciated your sticking by him?
Justin Marshall. Sneaking behind my back, are you? That's not his style. He never does that. Told everyone who'd listen to me, though, didn't I?
She is the only one that stuck by me through everything.
Of course, honey. I know who you are. You know, sly lowlife who's waiting to shoot somebody in the back. Whatever else you may be, you're not a murdering coward.
How can you know what reason someone had for shooting Alex Wheeler?
Elliot, how can you stand up for the killer?
Sorry, it's just... All my years as an investigative reporter have taught me that there are always... two sides. Two stories. Excuse me, I have to get back to work.
He's weird, huh?
Sometimes.
I bet Iris never would have married him if she hadn't been so...
She hadn't been so what, Rena?
Sorry, honey. Secret.
Good. Tell me.
Well, now, how can I expect you to keep a secret when I can't even keep it myself, huh?
Rena, it's not your secret anyway, is it? Now, I know you could keep it if you wanted to, but as I look into those two gorgeous brown eyes, I can tell you don't want to keep it anyway, do you? Do you?
Well... I promise not to tell.
Scout's honor, I won't tell another living soul. What?
Okay. Iris was pregnant when she married Elliot.
For that, I had to swear Scout's honor. Big deal. All right, so maybe it was in the 50s. It was sort of scandalous then, I guess.
Honey, you don't understand. Iris wasn't pregnant by Elliot. Dennis is Alex Wheeler's son.
You're kidding. You're not kidding.
No, I'm not. Iris told me yourself. Now, if you want further proof, Stryker said that Alex left one-third of his estate to Dennis. One-third, darling.
That's why Paige moved in on Dennis. It wasn't anything against Dawn. It was all that Wheeler money. I should have known.
Well, I think there are more important things in life than a little money.
Yeah, one of them is a lot of money. You know, Rena, some people do marry for money, you know.
Yeah, I know. But not me. I'm marrying for love, darling. Which, by the way, is why I'm here.
Get me to marry you?
No. Tell you that I'm getting married Monday.
You're not. Max.
Of course, Max. I told you he proposed to me. Now, why are you acting so surprised?
Well, I thought he'd probably have come to his senses by now.
Which is more than what you've done, darling.
Now, if that means I'm supposed to tell you not to marry Max, I'm sorry, Rena, I'm...
No, I may have wanted that once before, but not now. It's too late, Justin. I'm marrying Max on Monday. Now, you can come if you'd like. Suit yourself. Well, sweetheart, don't you have anything you want to say?
I know of a terrific honeymoon hotel in San Antone. I can personally recommend it.
I'll try to remember that, darling. If I can.
I'll never forget it, Rena. Pretend?
Mm-hmm. We're on a honeymoon. We're newly. You're about to sweep me into your arms and carry me over the threshold.
Why not? Let's pretend.
Here, Max is getting married on Monday, and he wants Ricky to be his best man.
Mm-hmm.
Well, so he kept asking how to reach Ricky. I didn't know what to tell him. I finally had to say I didn't think he could make it.
Tell him you were wrong.
Really?
Alex is bringing his yacht back from St. Croix right now, so Rick will be back in time for the wedding.
Wait, but how's he going to know there's a wedding?
Well, I'll get word to him. After all, we can't have anything get in the way of romance now, can we?
How nice to hear that sentiment expressed to me. Executive Office of World Oil.
Oh, Barrett, it's so good to see you again.
How are you, Terry?
How am I? How are you?
All here, I think. Just a few missing memories, which Ryan's going to help me find, I hope.
Well, I hope so, too. I sure do my best. Thank you, Barrett. Thanks for coming at such short notice.
There's no problem. Ginny had an appointment in Houston anyhow. I drove in with her.
Is this private? I mean, should I go?
Well, that all depends on what your boss here wanted to discuss.
Of course I respect your privacy.
Well, Bart, I didn't mean that you would shout my business all over the neighborhood. It's just that Courtney's your partner, and she's also Barrett's sister.
So?
I don't want Barrett informed. That is, if what I think is true really is.
Of course. Well, let me call Maria, my nurse. We'll see if you have any basis for this concern of yours.
Look, why don't you stay, Terry? We're going to be treading on some pretty thin ice here, so I think we can use all the level-headed advice we can get, all right?
Thanks for the compliment.
I guess you haven't changed that much, have you? Still strong and sensible.
Well, most things.
How about intrigue?
Who, me?
I'm serious. That's why I need your help here at... Look, why don't both of you sit down, all right? Barrett, remember when I asked you to do that Pentothal interview, I was investigating a crime, right?
Is that the interview I set up with Bart Walker?
Yeah, that's right.
But you never explained how my memories might help you. I don't even know what the crime was.
Somebody shot my uncle. and I think it was Elliot. But Elliot must have had some reason to fire the shot, right?
I think they did quarrel one day.
Do you know why?
No.
Okay. Alex was trying to force Elliot to leave town. I really can't tell you why right now. But Alex did have some kind of lever with which to do that. You see, he threatened to bring someone into Houston. Someone who could reveal what Elliot really did in that prison camp to survive the escape.
That's what all those calls to Bangkok were about then, huh?
That's right. Only Alex didn't realize at the time that Barrett was our star witness.
Without a clear memory of that escape. So no one knows what happened there.
Well, Alex did hear a rumor.
What?
That Elliot betrayed the escape to the Khmer Rouge to save his own life. That he really hadn't escaped at all. See, the refugees said that the guards just took him out to the border and let him go.
Carrington. He was the one who betrayed us. He was responsible for all those lives.
Wait. Lord. This is just a rumor. We don't have any proof, Barrett.
Damn it, I wish I could remember. If I knew he'd done that. If I could see it.
Even if it can't, you're still our best shot, Barrett.
How?
Help me shake Elliot into showing his hand. Which he'll do if he thinks your memory's returning. Now, even if it isn't, we just go along with me and pretend it is.
If Carrington is a killer, what is to stop him from going after Barrett?
Nothing. So you're right, Terry. It could be dangerous, very dangerous.
You ask my advice? I say don't do anything that'll put Barrett into any kind of danger. Not after what he's been through.
If Carrington's guilty of that betrayal, I'll do anything that needs doing. I have a promise to keep. To myself. What's your plan, Ryan?
All right, Ryan, now tell me again what you want me to do. Call Elliot and ask him to come visit me. Well, of course I can do that, but... All right, fine. About 6 p.m.? Yes. Yes. Goodbye. I hope that man knows what he's doing. Come in.
Iris? It's Rena, honey. May I come in?
Rena. Come in, please.
Well, I wasn't sure.
Oh, Rena.
Well, I know. You know, we've had words about Justin and all, and... Oh, honey, when I heard you were in the hospital, I just had to come by to tell you how concerned I was for you.
Rena. Such a good friend. And I owe you an apology.
Oh.
No, I mean it with all my heart. I was so wrong about Justin.
You really mean that, honey?
Yes, I do.
Oh, I'm so glad to hear you say that. We're friends again then, right?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Because you owe me a favor and I aim to collect.
I owe you a
favor?
Oh,
yes, you do now. I was your matron of honor at your wedding, even though
It's all right, Rena. Now, you were my matron of honor.
Yeah, and I want you to be mine. I'm getting married on Monday. Can you come?
You're getting married to Justin?
Now, why would I want to marry a crazy hothead like Justin Marshall? Honey, I'm marrying somebody 10 times better. Maximilian.
Maximilian? Decker?
Just a late hours place, you know? It's near Maggie's. As a matter of fact, it got me a job there. It's called the Chicken Coop. And, well, let me tell you, that place really starts jumping after midnight, you know? Got a nice country band and all. And I can fix it up so you can sing a couple numbers with them if you like. Make it a real coming out party. What do you say?
Look, we're not interested, okay?
Is that talking to you? What do you say, Elena? I tell you, the band is really good, but they need a voice like yours up front.
Oh, Jeb, let's go.
Well, I said forget it.
I thought this was my night.
Elena, I don't want you going to this place and getting up on stage and pretending like you're a singer, because you're not ready yet. This ain't the Metropolitan Opera, buddy. Look, why don't you just butt out? Why don't you do your job and get us a few drinks here, all right?
You're in my place now. I'm the one who tells people either to butt out or get out. You got nothing to say at the top of the world, you hear me?
Last time you had a lucky punch.
Now, come on, don't go spoiling my birthday. Sit down.
I'm not. This banana is.
Hey, all I'm doing is offering the lady a little opportunity here. She can take her to leave.
Well, she's leaving it.
I speak for myself, Jeb.
Elena, you're not ready, all right?
Not ready? You're crazy, man. You know that? I heard this girl sing before. She could have sing 6 months ago.
I'd really like to sing tonight.
You can sing tonight or as many nights as you want. I can get you a steady gig if you want.
No.
What's the matter, buddy? Afraid you might lose control over this girl or something, huh? Now, why do you want to go sabotaging her career for, huh?
You can really get me a regular paying job.
Sure can. Good pay, too. I'll tell you something. All you got to do is sing, please the people, please the crowd. I'll make you a star. You don't need this clown.
A regular singing job? Would you stop that? Give me this.
What?
Picking at the cake.
I always pick at cakes when I think.
Well, I'll cut it for you.
I was thinking about you.
You were? And what were you thinking about?
I'm just wondering what Max is going to do when he finds out.
You can serve yourself.
All right. I will do that. It's good.
Well, you better not get used to it because it's not going to be around.
Hey, wait a minute. Maybe I might want another piece. That's not very nice to do.
Well, it wasn't very nice of you to bring up Max either. I mean, I've already told you I don't care what he says anymore. I'm tired of him telling me what I can do and what I can't do and laying all these little guilt trips on me whenever I do something. And you have to keep bringing him up.
It's because I understand.
No, I think it's because you don't understand, Jeb. Thought you understood.
Yeah.
But you don't, do you?
Maybe.
No, you don't. I mean, if you did, you wouldn't keep on bringing up what Max is gonna think.
Elena, it's just that I thought that we had this deal.
Yeah, we had a deal, Jeb, and the deal was that I stay on the ranch and I practice my music with you until I turn 18. But I'm 18 now, remember? Or did you forget about last night?
No. I remember. But I just thought you said something about maybe you'd stick around if you and I were closer.
I said if we were lovers. Now, what are you saying, Jeb? Are you saying that you'll be my lover?
That's it, Mrs. Marshall. After you get dressed, just make yourself comfortable. Dr. Walker will be back in a few minutes.
Fine, thanks, Maria.
Sorry, I should have given this to you when we landed.
You know, I wonder.
Yeah, what do you wonder?
I wonder how long it would take people to find us on this island.
Would we want them to?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either. Long journey to get here, hasn't it?
Just across the room.
from the moment I saw you. You were riding at that horse show, right? I saw you and I knew that I wanted you. I wanted you more than anything else in the whole world.
I saw you too when you flew over the place. I looked up from riding and there you were hovering in the sky.
You look so beautiful. They're waving at me. What were you on, Lady Grey?
Oh, I wasn't just waving, Lloyd.
Oh, yeah?
I wanted to hitch a ride.
Where?
This beautiful island that I've been dreaming about for such a long time.
I'm sorry it took so long to take you to that island. So, you have any reservations now?
No.
Yeah, that doesn't sound too convincing. Come on, what is it?
It's nothing. I don't want to talk about it. I'm too happy right now.
Well, I'm happy too. Come on, what is it?
Oh, it's just this tiny fear that maybe you leave me alone. Call of duty. Go somewhere to help someone and I'll be alone. On a deserted island.
Ginny, look at me. That's not gonna happen. What do you think, I'm crazy? Leave a little island? No, our island is gonna be inhabited for the rest of our lives.
Well, Ginny, your suspicions were correct.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.
big deal about that. I can't turn my feelings on.